My name is Abhinav Jha. I am an officer in Indian Navy and I am an ultra runner by passion. I have been recently shortlisted to represent India at IAU 100 km World Championship at Croatia. Representing our country is obviously a dream come true for me, and also it is the culmination of last few months of efforts, because I always dreamt of representing India. I prepared for it and I prepared for it hard. My routine, the requirements of Navy, they were tough, but somehow I took time out and I always had that goal that yes, I have it in me and I'll definitely give my 100% and give it a shot if I am able to represent the country. And today, luckily, I'm here. The armed forces, we are required to maintain good physical standards. So that was the first step towards running. The first time I heard about ultra runs is in January 2017, that there is an event named Run of Kutch, which is supposed to be conducted in February. It was a very, very short interval of time, only 1 month left for the event. But I had just finished the Standard Chartered Mumbai Marathon in 2017. So I thought I am in shape and why not give this 100 km run a try. That was an event where I went completely unprepared. I was not aware what does it take to complete 100 km. What kind of physical standards, what kind of stamina, what kind of preparation goes in completing that kind of event. That was the time when I realized that yes, with my determination, I can complete anything which I start. So that gave me the confidence to try the ultra running again. So my second event was La Ultra at Leh. It is a high altitude race where the average altitude is approximately 12,000 feet or more. So at that place, it requires tremendous physical standards, mental strength, and a lot of planning to complete that kind of race. So I prepared for that race seriously for 3-4 months, and thereafter I went and participated in the race. My wife, she's been taking care of my nutrition and she's been ensuring that I take adequate rest during my training. So that has made my job to train very easy. My diet includes a lot of green vegetables, lot of seeds, lot of natural fruits, foods. So what I try to avoid is packaged foods, processed foods, and anything close to nature that I try to imbibe. And the best thing is that my wife has been a great support for me, and she has been ensuring all this for me for the last 1.5 years. Hydration, I personally feel, is very, very important to maintain your body functions in the normal manner. Secondly, depending upon the type of event you are preparing for and the separation between the aid stations, so you need to tune your body to like hydrate or fuel yourself after that interval. So that particular thing is very, very important to make a plan for hydrating your body and having the foods which you need on the route after a certain interval of time. I wake up at around 5 o'clock. At 5:45 onwards, I go for a small run. At least 2 times a week, I try to go for a longer run. After that, I have to rush for my office. Then after coming back from office, in afternoon, I go for a small cycling or power nap. 5 to 6 is generally games for the unit. Football or volleyball or maybe water polo. So that's like a recovery activity for me. I do a lot of cross training. Whenever I am feeling that my recovery is not going all right, I go for cycling instead of running. So we have our long swimming sessions. So that also acts as a cross training tool. I try to do at least one strength training workout in the gym at least a week, once a week. I sleep by 9:30 to 10 o'clock. I sincerely feel that whenever I am able to give good time for rest, that reflects in my training and that reflects in the faster recovery. Earlier when I was preparing for La Ultra, then I maintained my training logs manually because that time I was not having a watch. But now that I am having a Garmin Forerunner 935, automatically all my workouts are recorded. So I just go to my Garmin app and see what has been my weekly mileage, how many runs I have done at a slow pace, how many runs I have done at a faster pace, how many beach runs I have done, how many road runs I have done, how many hill workouts. So everything is recorded, so that makes my job all the more easier. But yes, some kind of discipline and some kind of planning is required to do your training in a proper manner. For preparation of this world championship, my weekly peak mileage has been 150 kilometers. And before that, I was maintaining an average of 110 to 120 kilometers in a week. For this event, I have done a long base training because in the month of April, I suffered from pneumonia. So thereafter, my fitness went for a toss and I had to recover well. So for recovering well and coming back into shape, it is very important to have the base ready. So that is why I did a lot of slow workouts, longer workouts, and I maintained a weekly mileage of around 80 to 90 kilometers for at least 2 months, and thereafter I took my training to the next level, that is 110, 120 and subsequently 150 kilometers. Everybody who steps into the ultra race, at the end or by the time the race finishes, he will suffer. He will endure pain, and that individual will have lots of problems on the route. So the best way is to get rid of those problems as soon as possible. So the best way of getting rid of those problems as soon as possible is to giving your 100%, trying to finish the race as early as possible. That is one thing. Second is, mental strength is very, very, very important to endure this kind of pain. And once you are mentally strong, then after a particular interval, it will start giving you pleasure. That pain will become your pleasure. So I have my moments in the race when I actually enjoy the pain. Like in the race in Malaysia, while running the race, I had 3 of my toenails which came out by the time race finished. But during the race, I didn't even realize that my nails are like going out. So it was paining, but then I had my target in mind and I had to somehow achieve it. So that's more important. A very important thing which I feel is choosing the event wisely and preparing for the event seriously. I see a lot of runners who run 4, 5 or maybe 6 ultra runs in a year, but they don't train for the event. Rather than participating in too many events just for the heck of it, I sincerely feel that giving a 100% for one race is the right way of going about a race. Yes, we can consider one of the race as a practice run for another race, but we should have our target in mind that yes, I am going to participate in this race and I am going to set a deadline or timeline for me and I am going to meet it. And we should have our plan ready how to meet that plan, meet that timeline. The first target is to give my best or give my 100% on the race day. And that has to be better than what I was yesterday. So that is my ultimate endeavor, that every time I step on the start line, I need to be stronger than what I was yesterday, and this drive or this journey should continue forever.